86 out, lots of humidity, still feels like close to 100 degrees. You see the winds coming in about 25 miles per hour. Definitely does not feel like mid-October outside. Still have some 90s and mid-90s, healthily in the 90s. In Hebronville, 95 there. The feel-like temperatures are up above 100 in a lot of places, as high as 107 in Beeville. All of this wind bringing up the humidity, wind sustained over 20 miles per hour for a lot of locations. You see some showers and storms missing the area. That's going to be the trend for the most part with the rain setup that we've got coming in. You see all this moisture streaming in from the southwest. That's coming off the top of Tropical Storm Pamela. This isn't expected to be as strong as originally forecast. Still going to get to hurricane status as it moves near Mazatlan tomorrow, but the remnants and the moisture from this going to track right through parts of Texas and some of the hill country, San Antonio up to near Waco and Dallas, going to pick up between 3 and 5 inches of rain. That's going to be the bullseye. We'll be a little bit more removed from that. I'm thinking less than 1 inch for the majority of the coastal bend, but our watershed may be in that 3 to 5 inch range. So that would be a helpful rain for that part of Texas. We do have also a moderate risk for flash flooding. Everywhere you see this red shade, I know the hill country very prone to flash flooding given the hilly terrain. You get more runoff and it can be very dangerous. If you have plans in that part of the state through tomorrow and Thursday morning, just be aware that there's going to be a flood risk. You see all the flash flood watches that are up and posted until 7 o'clock in the evening on Thursday. So we'll have a stationary front coupled with that moisture streaming in from Pamela. Again, it's going to be that swath of land generally along I-35 and points to the west and north that get the most rainfall. Then our attention shifts to a cold front. This is going to be a game changer for us. It's going to come through Friday evening and then bring us feeling like fall type of weather for the weekend. It's going to be nice. The front's going to move through here in the afternoon for the northern counties of the viewing area, early evening in Corpus Christi, and should be through the entire viewing area before midnight on Friday. We're going to go from the low 90s to the upper 70s, around a 15 degree drop between the afternoon highs from Friday to Saturday. Lots of north wind going to drop the humidity. It's going to feel great this weekend, a lot more like fall. Not really looking at much rain with the cold front, but we will have some before that front arrives, mainly Wednesday, and I think more so on Thursday. Wednesday, we'll start with a few little sprinkles out there. I think the most of the day is going to be quiet. It's going to be partly to mostly cloudy, highs in the low 90s. Into the evening, we'll start to see some of that influence, the rain from the Pamela remnants. You see the areas are going to be in the western and northern parts of the viewing area with the best chance for rain. That's Wednesday night. Here comes a little bit more Thursday morning. So in terms of the coverage, it'll be isolated near the coast. As you get farther inland, like north of the 59 corridor, the showers and storms going to become more numerous, but I don't think we're going to be in line for flooding rains. Maybe a half inch to an inch along that 59 corridor. You get closer to the coast, Corpus Christi, we're looking at a tenth to a quarter of an inch. So not a huge event, but it may fall right over the watershed, and that's where we want it given how wet it has been so far this year here. We'll stay close to 80 tonight, stay breezy, southeast wind 10 to 15 tomorrow, up near 90, another hot, humid, and windy day. The heat index value is going to be between 100 and 105 for a large portion of the area. It'll be choppy. Small craft need to use caution on the waters. 5-foot waves at a 6-second period. It'll be hot and humid through Friday. That front, though, comes in, and that really changes up our weather. 60s and 50s at night, Saturday, Sunday, upper 70s both weekend days, and that continues into early next week. Leslie, Mike.